back, artists. I'm excited about this week's project because we're going to be finishing our 3D relief flower pots. And this is one of my favorite projects to do because it really goes to show art can be made out of just about anything. If you look in the learning plan at a lot of the pictures I provided, you'll see that. I've gotten examples from the internet where people have made flowers out of all sorts of things. So check out those photos because they're very inspiring. And I've asked you last week to collect materials that you might find, maybe cotton balls, bottle caps, anything you thought might be interesting to make flowers. So you're really gonna base your work this week on what you have to work with. And that includes the kind of glues and tapes you have too. If you have a regular glue stick, regular glue sticks work really well for gluing paper onto paper or gluing other things that are light and thin onto your background paper or canvas. If you do have Elmer's glue or white glue, which I'll show you how to work with a little bit in the video, that works great for buttons, strings, anything that might be a little heavier to glue onto your paper. And just remember, all you need is a little dot, and that will help your materials stick well together. And you can always use tape, any kind that you have. So really just gather and collect everything that you have to work with, and that way it will be a lot easier for you to figure out how you're gonna make your flowers. And you'll see in some of my student examples, kids are using things like pom-poms and other things you may not have. But think about, how can you replace those with things you do have? Do you have any cotton balls? Do you have things that you would think would make great flowers? You can even just make your flowers out of paper or just draw them. In the learning plan, I've included directions for drawing different kinds of flowers. And there's a lot of examples of how you can make flowers out of almost anything. And you'll notice I don't give too much directions in this lesson because I really want you to use your imagination and work with the objects you have found over the week. It's your choice as the artist how you want to work this week.
So I just wanted to show you how you might go about gluing some things onto your background paper. This is my newest flower pot that I've been working on, and I'm using mostly string and tissue paper right now, but I am going to add some other collected materials after. And depending on what kind of glue you have, you might just have a glue stick, you might just have tape, so you're just going to work with what you have. Some students decided to just draw their flowers, so it's really up to you as the artist and depending on your materials. If you do have tissue paper or a thin paper, it really works well if you kind of crumple it up. You can kind of shape a unique flower. I find those work good. The glue I'm using is actually Elmer's white glue. It's kind of like the white glue you get in a bottle. And just like when you're using a bottle of glue, I'm using just one dot to glue things on because this glue is pretty strong. You only need a little bit, and things might move around on your paper at first. Like if you were gluing a bottle cap on, it might move at first, but once it dries, it stays very well. So now I'm putting more dots of the white glue on my paper so that I can glue a string down. And I notice the glue dries a little more clear later, but while you're using it, it may look white. And I took the stuffing out of my flower pot because I realized it's easier actually if you put it in at the very end. So you might want to take your stuffing out while you work on this and then put it back in at the very end of the project. So it's really fun, just play around with your flowers and your materials, see what might work. As you can see in the student example, there's so many different things you could do with this. And again, you might not have pom-poms. Those are the colorful little balls you see in a lot of my student examples, but you can use cotton balls, bottle caps, just so many things, different colored pieces of paper, anything you have. I know you'll be really creative and be able to think of different ways to make flowers coming out of your flower pots. You can even use leaves or rocks from outside, maybe. So have a lot of fun with this. I know you're going to be so creative. And if you want more ideas, look at the learning plan and see the examples I put in there, because I find the examples are really inspiring and gave me a lot of ideas of what I might want to do.
Awesome job, artists. See you next time.